Hello dear student, my name is Dr. Akhundzada Asaf Saeed.
My name is Nargiza.
Today we will give a lecture about the ECG, electrocardiogram, and we will show you that at which place we have leads, at which place we will put the leads, and for which purpose we do ECG. Okay, for ECG we have 12 leads, okay, or 12 electrodes, and we only use 10 electrodes. Okay, they are put at the chest region and under the armpit. Okay, and this electrocardiogram show us about the electric conductivity in the heart muscles, and also show us about the malfunctioning in the heart muscles or in the wall or any blockage in the wall. Okay, so we will show you now that at which place the leads we can put.
First of all, we are taking our tool, and people start from right hand.
Now you can see that this red color electrode we are putting in the wrist joint. Okay, you can put this lead any place between the shoulder and between the wrist joint. You can put here, you can put here, you can put here, you can put here, but we have put here the chest, right? Rest joint. Now, like this, we have put on the left side also, and you can see that Dr. Nargiza put it the lead the right side. You can put the lead between the ankle joint and between the tarsal joint at any point. Okay, but we have put here at the ankle joint, at the tarsal joint, and this is the right. You can see the color. Okay, don't you have to know about the colors of the lead and which color of lead we will put at which point. For example, red at the right arm, yellow at the left arm, black we will put the right feet, and green we will put on the left feet. Now you can see the leads of the electrocardiogram. Okay,
we are fixing our electrodes here. Red one to red, yellow one to red, yellow one, and green to green, and black.
Yes, you can see that the green and the black color. Okay, so green one we will put here, and then we will fix it. Okay, don't forget to fix the leads. Okay, so now you can see that we have put the electrodes at their place, okay, on the upper limbs and the lower limbs. Now Dr. Nargiza will show you that at the chest region, at which point we will put the leads. So first
we are taking this one, and this one here is have numbers C1, C2, and till the C6. And first point is,
it's the you know that this is the sternum region. Okay, so when we will put the V1 or the C1 lead, okay, we will like this. Okay, this four finger we will put here, the four finger. Okay, and then 1, 2, 3, and 4, fourth intercostal case. Okay, here at the skeletal you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4 first lead will be at the fourth intercostal pace. Okay, so we have put this lead at the fourth intercostal pace. Next V2 or C2 lead
C2.
We will put on the fourth intercostal pace, but right to the left to the sternum. Okay, and the fourth intercostal pace, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 left side for V1 or C1, and here we will have C2 or V2 fourth intercostal space, but on the left side of the sternum. So you can see C1 C2, RV1, RV2. Okay, now the fourth one.
We are taking fourth one.
Yes, we will put here 85th intercostal space. Like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, fourth intercostal space, and then fifth intercostal space we'll put here.
And third one, we forgot about third one, but we not forgot we are putting between C2.
Between the C2 and between the C4 at the fifth rib, okay, not intercostal space, at the fifth rib. Okay, so you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Four leads we already put on the chest. Now, you know that this is the clavicle, okay, and we divide the chest region in lines, okay. It is called as anterior axillary line, then mid axillary line, and then we have posterior maxillary line. So we have on the anterior axillary line, then we have C5 RV5 we will put here on the mid axillary line. You can see like at this point. It is also on the fifth intercostal space, okay? C4, C5 and C6, it will be on the fifth intercostal space. So this is mid axillary line, okay, under the arm fit. So you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six we leads are, you can see C leads, and four we have two upper limb and two in the lower limb. So in this position you will put the leads, or you can also call as the electrodes, okay. So at this, and then we will start our apparatus. So now you can see that, for example, like this. So now you can see that already started. It will start, okay, and when it totally it will give us the about the heart rhythm, about the heart everything, so now you can see that V3, V4, for every lead this apparatus will give us the, now you can see here that every electrode it will give. For example, we will start from, for example, V1 lead. It will give us V2, V3, V4, V5 and V6. This is the chest leads, okay? And then the four leads, 1, 2, 3 and four leads from the upper limb and the lower limb. So at this procedure, you will take the procedure of ECG, okay? And after this, when the ECG everything is complete, okay, then to any cardiologist or to the doctor who is treating the patient, okay, we will give this ECG, okay, and then we will
remove electrodes,
the leads, okay. But one thing I want to say, that before you are doing the ECG, you are starting the ECG, you have to ask the patient or to the family member of the patient that that we are doing ECG, and you will tell them that for which reason, because ECG show us about the any defect in the chest, in the heart wall, any defect in the walls of the heart, okay, or any defect in the aorta or in the coronary arteries, okay? And also this ECG show us that if the patient is using any cardiac medicines, okay, so this ECG will show us that this medication is useful for them, this medicine are helping the patient or not. So this is the procedure of ECG, okay, and at this procedure, at this like this, you will take the ECG. Thank you very much
for watching. Bye. Thank you.